Andrew Shouldice, creator of Tunic here at GDC. One of my top five games last year. You must be very proud.
I am very proud. Thank you so much. Couldn't have done it without you.
So, can you tell us what you were just saying to me about the starting point for making Tunic?
So, Tunic came, I think, looking back at it, from this feeling of hearing someone play a video game that I wasn't playing. I'm leafing through the instruction manual, right, while someone else is playing something and sort of letting the imagination run wild. And for a long time, I was trying to, you know, figure out exactly what a good word for this feeling was. And you said the word like mystique or mystery or something like that. And Tunic sort of came from that idea of what would it be like to make a game that tries its very hardest to evoke this feeling.
Definitely think you evoked a sort of emotional experience of coming to understand a world you know nothing about while stuck right in the middle of it.
Yeah, exactly. So this feeling of just being a tiny, vulnerable individual with a big world to explore, it's a really particular feeling of knowing that there are things out there to find and knowing that they're just beyond your reach. There's no designer necessarily, or at least the feeling of there not being a designer that's preventing you from finding something. It's just, you are digging where you dig. You're doing honest archaeology in this player ambivalent artifact, trying to find meaning. And I love that feeling.
Certainly, as I was saying, brought about a sort of universal nostalgic experience for reading manuals for games you didn't really understand back in the day. As someone who played games on the Commodore 64 a lot, there was a lot of that, because those games never told you anything. You had to leaf through the manual a lot. So what's next?
That's a good question. I think I'm still in break mode for a little while, and every time I think about making something, you know, doing some recreational programming or thinking about what the next thing would be, I think, well, what if it just didn't have any secrets in it? No secrets whatsoever. But I love secrets so much that that's hard. My mind automatically slips into this mode of trying to capture that same sort of feeling. And I don't know if that's healthy or not. Maybe I really need to branch out and try something different. But I don't know what's next.
Andrew Shouldice, thank you very much.
Thanks.